Over the weekend, the Central Executive Committee of the NRM Party, chaired by President Museveni, made a decision to retain the six incumbent members of parliament for the six NRM slots of the East African Legislative Assembly, including Akoruz Okulu, James Kakoza, Mary Mujeni, Musamali Paul Mwasa, Dennis Namara, and George Odong. Although this was good news to the incumbents, it was on the other hand sad news to the over 100 members who had come out to express interest for these seats. Together with their lawyers, the aggrieved members have today held a news conference in Kampala where they first petitioned the party, demanding it withdraws the decision to retain the incumbents, urging that this was illegal.
We reject this selection process and appeal as follows. A. That SEC quashes its decision taken before its outside mandate and powers. B. That the Electoral Commission of the NRM carries out a democratic electoral process as required and present winners to the NRM Parliamentary Caucus to participate in a free and democratic election as democracy requires.
Rutaro Robert Muhaire of Elgon Advocates, the lawyer for the disgruntled members, has issued a 3 days ultimatum to the Central Executive Committee of the NRM Party to adhere to the demands of his clients. Failure to do so, they are to seek court redress. According to Muhaire, the NRM Constitution gives powers to its members to contest for any position within the party. Therefore, it was very unfair to pull them out of the race without their consent.
And second, our clients to the NRM Parliamentary Caucus to campaign, converse for votes, and be voted for as the party flag bearers for the position of Eyala Member of Parliament in accordance with the law and particularly the NRM Constitution. If you do not do this within 3 days, our stern instructions are to unleash the legal machinery against you at your own cost and chagrin.
They are demanding that SEC instead forwards their names before the NRM Parliamentary Caucus for the elections.
To our dismay, before we reached home, we saw letters saturating that they have decided to endorse the six. That is not the democracy that took you, Mr. Chairman, to the bush. These people are misleading you. We need democracy. And I want to state it very clearly. His Excellency, our chairman, our MPs, our voters, every 5 years, they come back to the people to ask for their mandate and they vote for them. His Excellency the President, after 5 years, he comes back. We vote for him. Our MPs, they come back after 5 years. We vote for them. How come the six people, how special are they? Over the 40 million we have Ugandans. And it is not in the Constitution. It is not legal binding. Our lawyer is here, he can guide us on that. It is not anywhere in the Constitution of Uganda. It is not anywhere in the Constitution of NRM. So we appeal to you, Muzei, help us, as you had promised us before you in the State House. Let us appear to the NRM caucus and they choose and they vote for us. For you, they vote for you. The MPs, they vote for them. Why these six people? How special are they?
Like personally, I've said, Kukuza, Ozalendo, Katika, Jamii. We must communicate the community of communities.
Dr. Tang Odoi, the chairperson of the NRM Electoral Commission, has scoffed at these members, reassuring them that the decision by SEC on the Eyala seats was legally made.
And then SEC said, we shall advise. And the advice SEC gives, it gives to members of the party. And by law, that constitution they are quoting gives SEC the mandate to advise members of the party. And the advice is, we take the six. I'm not a lawyer myself. Like they said, I've done my part. I called for expression of interest, but they must know that I'm answerable to SEC, and which I did take. So even if they take me to court, I'll want to know what the charge sheet reads like. Even Rutaro, who is in part of this, Rutaro is a boy who grew up in NRM. He knows how NRM works.
Uganda is allocated 9 slots in the East African Parliament, but 6 of these are enjoyed by NRM, which has majority members of Parliament, and the rest of the 3 slots are shared among opposition and their independents. Report by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.